everyone, this is RayRay. Welcome to Hotel BARONG. And today I'm gonna teach you the basic of scratching from this beautiful Hotel BARONG kitchen. And thank you for Pioneer DJ Indonesia for giving us these amazing equipment, CDJ 3000 and DJ M900 Nexus 2. And you're gonna enjoy this video, and we're gonna start it right now. Let's go. So if you wanna learn scratch, if you wanna learn turntablism, you need to know something really basic, and you will learn it from this video. We're gonna start with like really, really, really basic stuff. We're gonna know what's the requirement of doing scratch or scratching. And so you need to have both sides CDJ loaded with the music you want. For example, I'm a left-hand scratcher, so my left hand will be on the CDJ, and my right hand will be on the crossfader most of the time when it comes to scratch. So, which means on your right hand, you need to have your music on. On your left hand, you need to have the one-shot, the sample, the vocal, anything you record, but it needs to be very clear with no music involved. Can be a cappella. That will be very, very good. So when it comes to mixer, so we need the vocal with a cappella to be very clear with no low frequency involved. So we're gonna turn down the low end so you don't hear any low frequency when it comes to scratch. And also, we need to have all the volume fader all the way up because we want both sides CDJ to play music. For now, we don't use crossfader, so we're gonna leave the crossfader in the middle. We only use the hand, which you're gonna put on the CDJ and scratch. So now, I'm gonna teach you the first thing of scratch. It's called baby scratch. So I'm gonna have a cue point on the very start of the sound, so you can find it, you can hear it. And you can also see on the Pioneer CDJ 3000 screen, and we're gonna cue a cue point on it, which will become a tag on the screen of the CDJ plat. So you will always follow the tag on the screen. So for the baby scratch, it's actually very simple. You just put the records forward and then put the records backward. So I'm gonna do it right now for you. And now, the most important thing for scratching, you actually need to follow the beat. So get your music ready. It can be anything, but don't get too complicated. It needs to be simple, like a hip-hop beat that will be ideal. I'm gonna find a hip-hop beat right here, and then we're gonna follow the beat and scratch. That's the baby scratch, so you can practice it now. All right, now we move on to the second scratch you need to learn, only with one hand, which is called drop. Drop is actually a little different from the baby scratch because you need to let go the records and then pull it back. That's called drop. I'm gonna do it right now for you guys. Okay, you got it? And now we're gonna follow the beats and do the drop.
Wow.
That is drop. And now, the third skills you need to learn from the scratch with one hand only is called tear. Tear is a little bit more difficult, but I know you will learn it. You will get it how to do it. So tear requires three sounds in two scratch, the forward and then the backward. So you either, they have two type of tears, either you go two times forward and one time backwards, or one time forward, two times backwards when you scratch. I'm gonna do the example for you right now. Remember, your hand is sticking to the plate of the CDJ. Alright, the other one is... Now I'm gonna do it on the beat. I'm gonna do it a bit slower so you will get it because this is more difficult. Okay, now this is tear. So now you can actually combine these three type of scratch with one hand only, either your right hand or your left hand, and into a combo. So I'm gonna do it for you guys, and you can also practice at home, and you can do different kind of combination. You can do drop, and then tear, and then baby scratch, or baby scratch, drop, baby scratch, drop, tear, tear, baby scratch, anything you want. I'm gonna do it right now. Now you learned how to baby scratch, how to do the drops, and then how to do the tears. And now we are moving on to the other hand. So crossfader is actually control the sound you want and then sound you don't want. If I put the crossfaders on the right, which means you won't hear any sound from the left CDJ. So if I put the crossfader on the left, which you won't hear any sound from the right CDJ. So I am a left-hand scratcher. I'm using my left hand to scratch, so my crossfaders will be always on the right. And then when I open it, I will hear the sound from the left CDJ. And when I close it, I will hear the sound from the right. I won't hear the sound from the left CDJ. So when I open the crossfader, you will hear the sound from the left CDJ. And then when I close the crossfader, you won't hear the sound from the left CDJ. So open, close, open, close, open, close, and open and close. And now we need to combine your left hand, the one which will be on the CDJ. And I'm gonna do this for you. And this one is called cut. You're probably very confused right now, but I will explain it. So when I open the crossfader and your left hand also let go the one shot, the acapella, anything you scratch on the CDJ, and when I close the crossfader, you pull back the record. So you will only hear one sound and you won't hear the pullback sound. So when we do the baby scratch or drop, you actually... You'll have two sounds, one and two, one and two. So I'm going to close the sound at two, so you won't hear the pullback sound from your records. And now the other skills that I want you guys to learn is called step. Exactly what you think. It's create the... You quickly do the forward and then backwards on your scratch hand, and then also at the same time you quickly step on the crossfader, so it will go up. You will hear a very sharp and chirpy sound. It's called step. So your thumb will be stick to the crossfader on the left, and then you use your fingers, other fingers, to step on it. So it's really fast. So you will hear a very, very short sound out from the mixer. So you literally do this. Yeah, it requires practice. Your left hand gonna put back the records really, really fast, okay? All right, this is called step. So we also do it on the beats as well. Okay, so now we combine these two crossfaders scratch together, so cut and step, and I'm gonna do it again with the beats. Now you will learn how to do that as a combo. This is the stab and the cut, the combo. And now, you probably already learned a lot, and we're gonna combine everything together. And I'm gonna do it with the beat as well. So I'm gonna remind you what we just learned today. We learned the tears, we learned the baby scratch, and we learned the drop, and then we learned another two things to scratch with your crossfader hand. It's called cut and step. So you know five scratch skills now, and we're gonna do it as a combination with the beats. Let's go. Thank you guys so much for watching the tutorial with me, and shout out to Hotel Borong, shout out to Pioneer DJ Indonesia. Thank you for the amazing gears again. I'm looking forward to see you guys next time. Bye bye.